Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. Last time we've arrived here on a small bluff. Well, you can see it on the map, right? There should be a Po around here somewhere, but don't think it's nighttime yet. I'm kind of always off when it comes to like time preferences, but I'm in the wrong place. I'm close to it though. I'm gonna go down here. There's a postal right back there. This is one that we want to go for because of the Po. Po must be found. There's a dig spot. Go! Take the soul! Yay! Okay, that one is 51 on numerical list, so I'm gonna check that one off. And now, gonna be heading near where we found the Bulbun camp. So yeah, we're gonna take the warp actually. It's gonna be a little bit faster that way. Warping! Because it's faster. Warping is faster than walking, people. Remember that. You want to warp when you can. Wait. My throat hurts. There's a Po right up there waiting above the cave of ordeals. I'm gonna take that soul from you, buddy. In numerical order, that one's number 50. Okay, so now we got 51 postals. Alright. Now we're gonna hang back over this way. Also, there's a Po that, if you recall, we left the Po alive back past them. Those Bulblins we found a while back. So yeah, we're gonna go around there, terrorize some Bulblins, kill some of them, and then we'll be collecting more Po's. Actually, we'll do that after I collect more Po's. I believe you wanna go over here. This part where the fairy is on the map. Should be... there's one. It's up there. Now, how do I get up there? Run! Run! Nighttime doesn't last forever. Sadly. We'd like for it to last forever, but it doesn't. Transform! Where's my claw shot? Up I go! Down I go. Transform into wolf. Hey you! You're guarding something. There we go. And take your soul. Alright, numerically that's number 46. Awesome. 48, 47 are down this big spot. So, down we go. Actually, I don't think it matters right now. Gonna just take yours right now, buddy. Don't know which number you were. Don't care either. You're dead. And I'll take your soul. So 47 and 48 are now marked off the map. Awesome. I'll transform into a human. And I shall climb my way out. There probably is a chest in here, but I don't care for it. If it had a piece of heart, I would care, but it doesn't, so I do not care. Alright, almost out of pose to collect. Not bad, not bad at all. Okay, now we're gonna go to the point where we fought King Bulblin. Yep. We're gonna go back to around the Arbiter's Grounds. Now I could warp to the Arbiter's Grounds, but it wouldn't take me right to where I need to be, so I'm just gonna go run around. And it's locked off. Thank you, Bulblins, for locking off the... oh, nope, no it's not. Yay! My destruction path has saved, thank you. Other than my very horrible destruction path. There it is. So number 49. I missed him a while back, and now I should take care of him. Hi, buddy. Oh, no, lemurs! No! If I'm gonna be forced to fight this guy again, it's gonna be because of you. Come down here. Alright, and Gerudo Desert has been cleared off, with the exception of the cave ordeals. That's 55 posts! Awesome! So, 55 posts cleared, there's 3 more in the cave ordeals and 2 in the city in the sky, which is where we're gonna be heading. So now I am to warp back to Kakugo Village. Awesome! 55 post souls, I cannot believe I'm actually getting 100% this game. Well, in terms of collectibles, I never really bothered with all the posts. Just five more! And the rest of them are in the Cave of Ordeals. And that's gonna be annoying. But we'll save the Cave of Ordeals for last, so we don't have to worry about that. Open up! It's me! I must talk to people! So yeah, there's only 5 more heart pieces left in the entire game. I feel pleased, actually. Skybook. They better not have said empty. Okay, said Phil. Okay, I was just mistaken reading there. Hey, Shad. There you go. I filled it for you. Poor guy. Oh well. He can't move it, but we sure can. I'm just gonna block his path. Dominion Rod has saved the very day for which we need to get to the next dungeon. What do you think, Linda? Let's warp it. Yeah. Kinda. You might want to go to Lake Hylia. No problem, I will. Just go to Lake Hylia, it'll be there before you know it. So Minna. Probably. Believe me, it's you're not the only one. Let's warp it. So Lake Hylia. So who would have thought that this empty little place of actually had a purpose? Yep. The nice little cannon to the sky. I feel kind of bad for putting off Shad like that, but meh. Right, I'm gonna go put that there. Put that over there. And now I shall talk to the annoyance that is free here, blah, blah, blah. I didn't build it. I need you to build. I need to fix it for me. If I built it, it'd be kind of shabby. So will you do it? 300 rupees. Ugh. I don't want to give you my money, but I must. I have to get to the sky. I'll pay you. My wallet is crying. My wallet is hurting because of you. Oh, that hurt my wallet. Okay, so now with our mighty cannon in tow, our collage shot in hand as well. Hi, Yuko. Is that a dragon? Please tell me it's not a dragon. Another Uka! Or Uku. They're speaking gibberish! We just saw a dragon fly past us! What were you doing? Right, the city in the sky. This is our third to last dungeon. It's the last place for the mirror shards, that's for sure. I'm gonna go shopping first, and then I shall start the dungeon! Yeah! I'm kind of a big fan of the City of the Sky. In the sky. Whatever. Kind of just want to buy things. Male sex sign, double star, female sex sign, some kind of multiplication with dots around it, double star. What were you speaking before? I got plenty of money. Lantern oil, why would I need that? Blue potion? Man, that actually might be helpful during the Cave of Ordeals. I'll come back here for those. I'm gonna buy more of these because I got more room in my bomb bags. And now I am poor. Definitely after this dungeon, I'm going to be looking for lots of rupees. Or rather, I'm going to be going back to those rupee chests and then coming back here to buy, or rather going to Malamart and buying Blue Potion. Because then, I think after the second dungeon, after the next dungeon we're going to the Cave of Ordeals. That's for sure. Ooh! Chest. I must open chest before I end the part, and then start dungeon. Iron boots. Open chest. And, what be inside? Bombs! Yeah, it's helpful. And my bomb bags aren't full, so that really is helpful. Right, another chest. I must go open chest before I drown. Actually, you know what? Before I drown? Just gonna go put that on. It's been forever since we wore the Zora armor. Not boots. And the red rupee. Yay. Any other chest in this thing that I can find before I go back up to the surface? Nope. Okay. Swim up. And next time, on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, we're going to go start the city in the sky. I'll see you all next time.